Hey guys, welcome back to another Let's Play on Fallout New Vegas. Let's jump back into it, shall we? I don't like continue while I'm doing the continue one because it usually doesn't work for me. Let's see where we're at. We're right here. Sorry guys, I'm trying to play radio. Actually, I'm not sure if I should or not. Let's see. You still got the mail. Not sell those. You guys want to see something funny? Well, it's not here. There it is. Sorry about that. So, nope.
Thank you.
Why do you have a Chinese thing? That's it. I want to mess with this one. Let's see if there's a door. Yep, there's a door. Where is it? Where is it? That's it.
If you're looking for supplies, check.
Okay. Go sell some stuff.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching. I've got plenty of supplies. If you're hurting, can't.
HDMI 2.
Another satisfied customer. The leader was a New Vegas type. Typical city boy. He had a bunch of great cons with him, probably hired guns. The great cons normally stay in their own territory way up northwest on account of them being enemies with the NCR. They're tough sons. The great cons deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by great cons. Take it easy now.
Didn't see that before.
Hi there, sticking around. Sure can. And see, off. Not in Good Springs, no. But if you're up for a little scavenging, there's always the school. Most of what's in there is junk, but there's this old safe that even Easy Pete wasn't able to crack with dynamite. If you want to take a shot at it, take these. If the lock's too much, you'll need those to pick the lock. Be careful, though. Put too much pressure on them, and they'll snap. Always happy to help someone down on their luck. I hunt geckos mostly. I also help keep the town clear of rat scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in Good Springs, so wildlife is always creeping in. Sure, what? Southeast of here is Prim. Can't miss it, since it has the giant old roller coaster right in the middle of town. The NCR's got an outpost there. If you follow the road north, you'll eventually hit Sloan and Quarry Junction. They mine rocks or something, but I heard they got troubles lately. I wouldn't head that direction if I were you, though. Got critters up there that don't take kindly to getting shot. Around here, mostly coyotes and geckos. The coyotes are pretty dangerous in large packs, but otherwise they're nothing to really worry about. The geckos aren't too tough, but they've got a nasty bite. I've heard about bigger, nastier versions out in the wasteland, but I've never seen them. Stick to the roads when you can, and steer clear of the hills north of Good Springs. The critters up there are big and poisonous. If you want to know, until next time.
I'm done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
What the hell is your problem? What do you want? He's some trick would serve these. It is now. Me and the rest of the guys busted out of the NCR prison east of here and took over. Now we're calling the shots. None of your damn business. Robbed some people, burned some things, killed a few guys. Same old shit that's been... Never been there since... Yeah.
Well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon. Looks like our little town got itself dragged into the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him. He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill. You mean Mert? Some of the others, like Sonny, will probably stand up for Ringo if he asks for help, which he hasn't. Personally, I hope he sneaks out of town one night and takes the Powder Gangers with him. Chang gangs, really. The NCR brought them in from California to work on the rail lines. Problem is, it turns out that giving convicts a bunch of dynamite and blasting powder isn't the best idea. It was a big escape not too long ago. Some of them stuck together so they could make trouble. That's what we're dealing with now. There's a... If you... Don't know why you'd want to do a thing like that. Yep, you'd get on their good side, but people around here wouldn't appreciate it one bit. He's a convict, just without the chains. Said his name was Cobb. Powder gangers is what they call themselves. Plenty more like him out there. Not much, other than they're a bunch of freeloaders who expected a few rounds on the house. I was able to get them to pay up, though. Of course, one of the great cons did knock my radio to the floor, by accident, and it hasn't been working since. They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. Sounded like they came in from the north through Quarry Junction. If that's the case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back. That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them. Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive, which it could be for all I know. I didn't hear exactly, but the leader was talking about the strip. Fellow wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up. Sure, the outside. There'd be caps in it for you. I do like to hear what's going on in the world. And that Mr. New Vegas seems like such a gentleman.
I need this.
Feeling thirsty? Yeah, I heard it turn ripe.
Oh.
You're welcome. So can I get you anything? Got a Give me a shout if you need anything else. I know that thing as much as anyone else around here. It mostly keeps to itself, which is just fine by me. Other than rolling around once in a while, it doesn't do anything useful as far as I can tell. I don't know why it took an interest in you, but I'd be careful. It's never helped anyone before. It acts friendly enough, but I don't trust that whole cheerful cowboy act. I find it all very creepy. It was here when I took over the saloon 7 years ago. Some people have said its owner lived here, but no one knows who it was. Fine by me. Mostly traders. Most travelers heading south on the I-15 just push on towards Prim, unless they're in desperate need of supplies. Be careful out there. Evening.
Howdy.
Who are you barking at?
Hey there. Hi there. Sticking around?
Yep.
Until next time.
Oh, she didn't bob. Let's wait.
Hello there. It's good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes. Don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and... Ah, screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on. There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there, is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars. All over the place. Other than bottles. It's said that the treasure is guarded by a man named Festus, and he's the one who asked for the blue star caps. It's also said he's been around since the war. Standing a lonely vigil, waiting for someone to come and take the treasure off his hands. That'll make him pretty damn old, but I've met a few people in my travels who claim they actually met him, and they weren't the lying type either. Nah, I gave it up years ago. Too dangerous. And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps. No one knows. Money, weapons, water. It is, or maybe was, something of value, and that's enough to get people motivated. No problem. Huh? You want to talk? Oh, that's right. Here, let me show you what I've got on hand.
Oh, he's got a magnum. Hold on, dude. No, you don't want these. Why did I do that?
Huh? You want to talk some more? Oh, that's right. You want to talk some more? There's not much. If you say so.
Have fun with them again. We get more of these collection of those. Oh, yeah, that's right. Gotta. There we go.
That's close enough. Who are you, and what do you want with me?
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan? You know how to play? It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pot. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids. So there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see Caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced. And more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So, you feel like playing a game? Just keep an eye out for him while you travel. I've found cards in old boxes or forgotten on shelves. Can find some for sale, too. All right. Yeah. He doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight. I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own. We just end up sharing the... Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
All that? I want that. Ooh, stop this guy. Why are you coming over here? Go back over there. No. Go away. I'm gonna help. There you go. Come back to that later. Ain't that funny?
Welcome back. Well, I already seemed like I found that. Well, ain't we all, right? That was a long time ago. I don't pay it much mind anymore. I didn't see him or the men with him. You might ask around town, though. Could be someone saw which way they was headed. Your best bet would probably be Trudy, the bartender at the saloon up the road. If anyone saw anything, she'd know about it.
Okay.
You take care now.
Trudy! No, get back here. Don't go through that door. Oh, yeah.
Is there?
What was it? Yes.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while? Say no more. Just like that. I have a feeling that I'm going to end up fighting those guys one way or another. So I might as well get it over with. Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo. But I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere, and Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great. I don't think Giv is in Chet's for... A silver tongue would help. Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight would also help. Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before you handed it over.
All right.
I'll be waiting.
Talk to him first.
Howdy. Too dangerous. Uh-huh. Guess you know what you're doing. I'll go dig it up and get it ready. You'll have it by the time the fighting starts. Yep.
I like him. He's funny.
Howdy.
Howdy. How are you? Why are you always sick of me, man?
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
Yeah, I'm gonna do this one.
I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
Alright.
Be careful out there.
I have a feeling I'm not going to be able to get most of it. But let's try first. Let's see if I can make it. Why would I want to make that? Oh. also have weather bags.
You looking to buy some supply? Now just hold. If Ringo doesn't head out on his own, I think we should hand him over. The town shouldn't get itself mixed into the problem. Don't mistake that for coward talk, though. We're a town of survivors. We'll fight tooth and nail if pushed, but we don't go looking for trouble. Take it easy now. You looking to buy some supplies? You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand. Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines. Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easier. There's also hollow point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor. Take it easy now.
All right. Yeah, I like this mod, guys. Makes everything seem more realistic. Because who wants to play when it has no weather? Maybe I should wait. Shouldn't I wait? Yeah, I'm gonna wait till this is over. Actually, oh great, I'll turn on thunder. Doc Mitchell, need to talk to you. After you sit down.
How are you holding up? Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone. Oh, I'm not much good in a fight with my bum leg. And my supplies are scarce, but I'll give you what I can spare. You take care now.
All right. That's everyone. I'm going to go to the schoolhouse first. I should probably heal too. If you guys know how to turn off Steam notifications, that'd be great. Did I get him? Yep, I got him. That's one. Crap. It's two. Suck at aiming. Okay, that's it. I'm getting attacked by freaking ant things. Well, mantis. Die. Isn't that quite... Oh, hello. What is a nuclear crawler truck doing here? Well, it is a school, so. If y'all want to know how to do this really easy, to get rid of all the non-essential ones, you just gotta look for these types. Yeah, can't speak. It has to have one right here and another one right there. So like these. This one. Sometimes I only get so lucky. Let's see if there's another. I do not see another one. Darn it. There we go. Let's see if I can. Get out of here. No, I didn't even see that. There's nothing in it, so. Oh well. Another gun. Actually, guys, hold on. There we go. Think I'm ready, guys? I don't think so. I feel like I'm gonna die. Well, no, not really. All right, we're ready, man.
So what's going on? Well, I guess that means we're ready to go. Unless you think there's something else you can do. All right, I'm ready. I hope.
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play. At least six, Joe Cobb included. They look pretty mean. Oh, Easy Pete came through with the dynamite. Here's your supply. I really hope I don't blow myself up. I'll be set up near the store. Let's hope that the gang doesn't manage to make it that far.
I'm gonna get it that way. This one doesn't want more. Why you gotta run so fast, man? I don't run so fast.
Hey, do that somewhere else.
Hey, I'm shooting them.
You a huge favor for this. Here, these are technically Crimson Caravan funds, but I know they'll understand once I explain things. I did have what was left of the Crimson Caravan money, but I wasn't sure if it was my right to just give it away. I owe you more than that, though, so look me up at the Crimson Caravan camp up in New Vegas if you ever visit.
All right. Will do.
That'll teach the Powder Gangs to avoid... Until...
That was a hell of a fight. Let's hope it doesn't...
Here, you can have that back. Oh man, he just got that.
Let's see what else I can sell.
Give me a shout if you need anything else.
Okay.
Take it easy now.
Let's get going. Let's start retreating.
Thanks again for all your help. I've never stopped here until recently. You're better off asking one of the locals. Yeah.
Oh, hello. Trudy?
That ought to keep things settled for a while. Bad trouble. Welcome.
Hmm.
Yep.
Trudy. Trudy. Trudy.
I'm glad that business is over. I like it when Good Springs is nice and quiet.
Okay. Nothing
else. Be careful out there.
Alright, guys. Gonna end it here. If y'all like this video. If you like this video, subscribe, like it. It'll help out me in the long run. And like always, I will see you in the next video. Later.